Good evening and welcome. Welcome to Wednesday evening prayer, and to those who've logged in and not logged in, you are more than welcome. I'm lighting a candle now for peace, and especially for my brothers and sisters, past and present, of the Teo community of Interfaith Franciscans. And we pray that the Father, Mother, God will send more brothers and sisters to the community, and that we can all work together for unity and peace. We begin our evening office of Vespers for the fourth Wednesday of Lent. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O God, creator of us all, from whom we come, to whom we go, you look with pity on our hearts, the weakness of our wills you know. Forgive us all the wrong we do, and purify each sinful soul. What we have darkened, heal with light, and what we have destroyed, make whole. The fast by law and prophets taught, by you, O Christ, was sanctified. Bless all our penance, give us strength to share the cross on which you died. O God of mercy, hear our prayer. With Christ your Son and Spirit blessed, transcendent Trinity in whom created things all come to rest. And our first antiphon this evening: how wonderful is this knowledge of yours that you have shown me, Lord. And now we read Psalm 138. O Lord, you search me and you know me. You know my resting and my rising. You discern my purpose from afar. You mark when I walk or lie down. All my ways lie open to you. Before ever a word is on my tongue, you know it, O Lord, through and through. Behind and before you beseech me, your hand ever laid upon me. Too wonderful for me this knowledge, too high beyond my reach. O, where can I go from your spirit? O, where can I flee from your presence? If I climb the heavens, you are there. If I lie in the grave, you are there. If I take the wings of the dawn and dwell at the furthest end, even there your hand would lead me, your right hand would hold me fast. If I say, let the darkness hide me, and the light around me be night, even darkness is not dark for you, and the night is as clear as the day. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. How wonderful is this knowledge of yours that you have shown me, Lord. And the second antiphon: I am the Lord who tests the mind and heart. I give each man what his conduct deserves. For it was you who created my being, knit me together in my mother's womb. I thank you for the wonder of my being, for the wonders of all your creation. Already you knew my soul, my body held no secret from you. When I was being fashioned in secret and molded in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw all my actions, they were all of them written in your book. Every one of my days was decreed before one of them came into being. To me, how mysterious your thoughts, the sum of them not to be numbered. If I count them, they are more than the sand. To finish, I must be eternal like you. Oh, search me, God, and know my heart. Oh, test me and know my thoughts. See that I follow not the wrong path, and lead me in the path to life eternal. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I am the Lord who tests the mind and heart. I give each man what his conduct deserves. And the third antiphon, all things were created in him, and he holds all things in being. And now we have a canticle reading from Paul to the Colossians. Let us give thanks to the Father, Mother, God, who has qualified us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. He has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of their beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of our sin. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation, for in him all things were created in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile himself to all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the death of his cross. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. All things were created in him, and he holds all things in being. And now for our special reading for this Wednesday evening of the fourth week of Lent, and it's from Paul to the Romans. My brothers and sisters, I implore you by God's mercy to offer your very selves to him, a living sacrifice, dedicated and fit for his acceptance, the worship offered by mind and heart. Adapt yourselves no longer to the patterns of the present world, but let your minds be remade and your whole nature thus transformed. Then you will be able to discern the will of God and to know what is good, acceptable, and perfect. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the short responsory, I said, Lord, have mercy on me. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. And the antiphon for week four, the Father knew that was the hour when Jesus had said to him, your son will live, and he and his household believed. And now I invite you to join me for the canticle of Mary the Magnificat. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God who is my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength, and he scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones, and he exalts the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, and sends the rich away empty-handed. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers Abraham and his sons forever. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Father knew that was the hour when Jesus had said to him, your son will live. And he and all his household believed. And now for our evening prayers and intercessions. Let us praise God, our Father, Mother, who hears the prayers of their children and grants what they ask. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. Lord, on Sinai, you gave the law to Moses and completed it through Christ. Write your law in the hearts of all men and women, that they may be faithful to your covenant. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. Help to us to create a community where people care for one another. Let us work together for the good of all. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. Strengthen missionaries when their courage fails. Send them helpers to gather in your harvest. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. May children grow strong in grace. May the young advance with your love. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. Remember our brothers and sisters who rest in your peace. Make them sharers of eternal life. Response, Lord, have mercy on your people. And now we come to a quiet time where we bring our requests and intentions to our loving Father, Mother, God. And this evening, I would like to pray for each one of you. And especially, I want to pray for dear Sister Sue and for her Aunt Evelyn and all their family. I pray for all religious leaders around the world, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, His Holiness, the Dalai Lama, and our Queen Elizabeth, head of the Church of England. But I also give thanks to God for all the brothers and sisters of the Teo community of St. Francis, both past and present members. And we pray for all our members on Heart to Soul Prayer Partners for Peace, and for the many who have asked our prayers, too many to mention. We just bring our book of intentions and requests to our Father, Mother, God, and say thank you for answering the requests of those we bring to you each day. So let us now, dear brothers and sisters, pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, Mother God, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us tonight our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now for our closing prayer. Lord God, you give the world new life by mysteries which are beyond our grasp. May your church not be deprived of earthly help while she makes progress by the strength of these eternal gifts. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus the Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And that, my dear friends, brings us to the end of Vespers for this Wednesday evening. I'd like to conclude now with a Celtic blessing. The blessing of heaven, the blessing of earth, the blessing of sea and sky, on those we love this day, and on every human family, the gift of heaven, the gift of earth, the gift of sea and sky, the gifts of brother sun and sister moon and the animal kingdom, be in our hearts, now and forevermore. Amen. And when I blow out this light, I blow the peace, the love, and the joy of the Christ into your heart. Amen. Namaste, shalom, inshallah, pax et bonum, om shanti, solo di caritas, salam alaikum, and may the peace of all that is sacred to you reawaken your heart to the presence of God within. Thank you for joining me. Have a blessed evening, and I look forward to your company again. Good night. And God bless.